Alright, today we are going to continue painting the Akhelian Queen. So we're going to start with her face, like we usually do, on people models. If I can find the correct color to be using, where is it? That's right here. We use the pale flesh color that we usually use for our flesh tones. Let's get this guy. Let's get some paint on our brush. And let's get her skin. You can see there's a lot of spots that we kind of got with the airbrush last week, but should be fine. Should be able to cover up all of those spots with this. Maybe it'll take a couple coats though, because this might be pretty transparent. So let's just paint all the fleshy bits on this model. The neck and the shoulders. Try our best not to hit the sea dragon, because how we painted it, would be hard to clean it up. Is she wearing? Looks like it's usually a dude model. It looks like it's not wearing a shirt, but I think I'll paint shirt colors onto it anyway. So let's just paint the hands. I don't know though, maybe to go more mermaidy, maybe she's not wearing a shirt under the armor. It's kind of just up to us to decide. We have our wood elf heads on these guys. That'll do that for the skin. Now we'll do the undersuit. I'm gonna go for a blue undersuit. So we're gonna use that toxic mist color from War Painter, from Army Painter. So I'm thinking purple for the cape also, but since the guy is mostly, not mostly, it is purple, it might not be smart to put that color as the color of the cape. I might go pink, so we'll see when we get there. Trying to avoid hitting the undermodel as much as possible. Trying to get good coverage here. And that's a shot really quick, hold on. Okay. go in there. Let's turn it upside down so we can see if we can get in there better. Now we can get the arms and see how like a doing it as an undershirt would look. Looking pretty good. Get the other arm. See if we can get in there, how best we can get in there. Hidden lots of other colors in there, but I think we're good. I think we got it all. Okay. Oh, now we got actually some in here. We've got like insides of her armor over here in the front. So you just take your time, find your spots. Whoops, hit your camera. Wouldn't be a video if we didn't hit the camera. Cool, so that's all of those spots, I think. Now, we're gonna go for the armor. For the armor, we're gonna go gold. Yeah, we're gonna go gold. But there's lots of other stuff on here too, like this. Might go purple for the sheaths, we'll see. That might be the smart play. So I'm probably gonna go silver for the trident also. I don't want too much gold on the model, just to blow it out, so we'll see. So we got this bright gold from Army Painter. Never used this paint before, so we'll see how this goes. Since I was out of gold and this, I was pretty much out of gold and the store was, didn't have any of the kind that I usually use. So we'll see how good this guy does. War Painter stuff is usually a little bit more watery, which is fine, because you're supposed to thin down your paints anyway, but we'll see. See how transparent it looks and stuff once we get it all on here. We'll have to get the stirrups and stuff separate. Yes. Yes. Oh, is everything okay? Oh, okay. But it's going on pretty good. It's a little light, but that's okay. Because when we wash it with the red wash, it should brighten it up a bit and make it look a lot more vibrant. Get all her panel, armor panels colored. try to avoid hitting the blue that we put on earlier. It's gonna be a little tricky getting in here. Steadier your hands, the better. The easier this will be for you. But if you don't have steady hands like me, you'll just kind of have to live with whatever mistakes happen when you do this, and try to touch them up later. Has a lot of holes on it, so you might have to go a little thick on the paint on your brush just to get it to move around. This model is very wobbly. So you have a lot more opening on this side since their hand is up. I'm just gonna paint over everything right now, and here we'll get the gems and stuff on it in a minute. You should get the underside of this too as best you can. One day I'll have an episode where I don't hit the camera. One day. Make sure we're getting all of the armor. Yeah, I did. Okay, I missed a little spot back there. On the up there. There. Let's go move around the hair to get the spots that it's covering. Still trying to avoid hitting that blue. See, since we got the overspray on the purple here, you can see a lot of the purple through, so just using a little bit thicker bit of paint on my brush to get that done. Inside here now. Oops, I hit it. No, I didn't. Okay, I hit the camera though. Okay. So she's all golded up. We're also gonna do the gold trim on here, but we have to do the base of it first, so. Let me get her wristbands painted. really fast. Through here. Okay, now we gotta get her crown. Okay, now we can move on to, should we do the hair really quick? Yeah, we can do the hair really quick. We're going to make it red hair. So we're going to use this vermilion from Vallejo. I'm going to thin it down with some white. I'm going to pale it out a little bit more because this is super bright red and I don't think we want a super bright red. So we'll use some white, throw that in, just mix it up a little bit on the side palette over here. We don't want it to be pink, but we don't want it to be this red. Okay, I think that's better. Okay, so grab the model. Some hair on her face here. More paint. Oops. Oh no. Shit. Well, that sucks. We'll have to go back over that. More paint. Okay, then we have her hair done. Ugh, I can't believe I hit that. But we have some blue on our palette still, so we'll be able to take that toxic mist color and go back to here and clean up where we accidentally hit it. Okay, so let's go for the purple. Where is it? Here it is. The blue violet from Vallejo. Actually, no, there's a different one. We're gonna use this one. Pretty close, but this oozing purple from War Paint Army Painter. Because we're trying to keep that pastel motif through this whole thing. as best as we can, and we're gonna get the sheath with it. So let's take the color, put it on here. I'll make these this color too, the hairs. God damn it, stop it. Let's do that. That's good. Let's get these gems really quick. We'll use like a let's use this blue from Vallejo to get those gems. It'd be like gems of the sea or something. Let's take that. Get a nice point on our brush. We don't want this stuff to spill. This stuff is a little watery, so I'm gonna be careful when we touch the thing and see what happens. Let's see, we got one there. And there's one on the chest arm for her armor. Right there. Cool. Now let's take our, let's do our browns right now, just while we're here. Let's take our leather brown from Vallejo. Get the strappy bits. It's not a whole lot. There's gonna be the stirrups that we want to do. So we wanna get these guys. Just use a light touch with your brush. Don't push too hard, or else it's gonna spill everywhere. And you don't want that. So try to keep your hand as stable as possible. There we go, I got that. Get the little wrap on the sword here. Okay. Now what do we do about this trident? I think she has like a little wrap here too to hold the sword on her back. So we'll get that with this brown too. Stop hitting this, Jesus. Okay, stop, okay. Okay. And we can get, this is a tombstone of some sort, so we'll get that later. Now for the cape. I don't think the pink's gonna be too much with her hair being red. I think it'll be fine. Get some more of this in here really quick. Missed a spot on her hair. Just touch that up really quick. Okay. I think it'll be less. We're gonna use a centaur skin color from Army Painter. We'll see how well this goes on. I anticipate it being pretty transparent, so we might have some problems on the inside of the cape where we hit it with the purple on accident, but we'll see what happens here. So just take it and start brushing it on. like I said, we're gonna go over the symbols and stuff with the gold. So I wouldn't, don't worry about it right now. We're just painting the main cloth. Make sure you're getting in between all the little spirals and stuff on the cape. Lots of little bits on here. Make sure your paint is flat and it's not like clumping up on things and leaving streaks. You don't want that. This model's very bouncy. I'm gonna try to put it on as smooth as possible. We'll also use this color for the coral on the base. That's like on the little decorative bit. So I'll try not to forget that. Sticking through the top there. It's cool to leave some white of the white showing underneath. It makes it kind of look, gives it a little bit more depth and stuff, but we're trying to cover up as much of the purple and other colors on here as we can. And we may or may not wash the cape. Probably will, but like I said, it dulls that color out. I mean, it darkens that color, so we'll lose some of the pastel when we wash it. So you might have to go back later and do like a dry brush over the top just to get the pastel-y colors to return. But for now, we'll just see how it works. Pink cape's looking pretty dope. Just kind of go try to get your paint strokes all in the same direction, so that if they do show up, at least they're all flowing in the same direction. Take some of this and just hit the bottom. Do your best to get up in here. You're just looking at the bottom of her base right now. And then we can go flip this way and really get in this little nook right here. Go, our queen now has a pink cape. I'm gonna clean up here around the spikes, because a lot of the blue did get in there. So let's to get that. Okay. Clean up these edges here. Even though they're probably going to be gold, so. But yeah, like I said, the gold might be too much, so we might not do the gold. We might do a different color. Maybe a blue? Who knows? Okay, our cape is done. Now let's go for the shields and the trident. We're gonna go for like the same kind of color that we had on here on the thing. So we're gonna go with the silvers. We use this mithril silver from Citadel. for a lot of the, for all the metals on the model. If I can open it without exploding it everywhere. Okay, cool. So, let's get this shield painted. Ooh, you can see a lot of purple right here on the pink, so I'll have to go over again in a second after it dries a little bit to try to get another coat on there. So let's get these metals painted on here. Get the inside of the shield. Here's the inside of the shield painted. Let's get the little rest of the metal-y bits on the scabbard here. And let's paint this whole trident. Apparently I got some red on her too, so we'll have to fix that. Maybe I'll make the head of the trident gold. That might be cool. Let's clean all that up. Shield here. Let's get that skin tone again. Touch up the hand that we hit. Just to clean that guy up. Did miss a little, we did miss the coral, so let's just get that centaur skin color and go back in here and get the coral down here on the base. We gotta go in here and get that spot that was purple still. Also, the reins that we may have messed up when we painted the other colors. I can definitely see some. I don't know if I'll be able to get it though. Okay, let's clean this up here. It's fine, it's fine. A bigger spot here. Okay. Okay, now we're gonna go back to the gold that we had. If I can find it on my palette. Which I cannot, so we're gonna grab this bright gold again. pour it in. To get into the whole tip of the trident here. And this had like a skin tone, like a flesh tone peach for the trident. So I think this will look really good with the mixing with this gold color. It'll really pop, make it pop more. Okay, let's see if we okay. Now we're gonna take this German camo beige World War II from Vallejo to get like the teeth parts and the, like not the teeth of her, but like the shark teeth on the armor and the sand on the base and the wrappings. So I'll take this. Right here, get a little shark tooth. And this little guy on the bottom here. Shark tooth. Little wrappings. Get the sand on the base. Painted. Is there any other spots that we're missing? No, okay. Okay, lit. Let's try to get the gold on the cape. So, I'm gonna get a fair bit on the brush, and then we're gonna, as best as we can, try to get all the details with the gold. The pink is pretty forgiving, so if some of it shows through, it'll be okay. I'm just using the light hand, as light as a hand as we can get. Really trying to stabilize it as best we can. Just trying to lightly go over the top of this whole thing. Get the gold to show. So we're gonna keep at that for till we get all this covered. And my hands are shaking worse the more I concentrate. So let's just keep hacking away at this. Try not to get it on the pink. We did a little bit, but it's okay. Just keep a light hand. Mm. of filled in there a little bit, but so we were able to get the gold in there. Did an okay job. We're gonna let the paint dry out a little bit more. We're gonna take this medium sea gray to get the like gravestone that's down there. Super watery. That gray, like a stone headstone. A lot of stuff's gonna show through it a little bit, that's fine. It'll give it kind of a sea glow. Purple. Just get that really quick. Okay, so now we can do our washes and contrasts, I think. So like the thing we did a contrast paint on the, for like the fins over here. Ooh, that did not show through really well. Okay, so we're gonna get her haven't eaten today, so that's probably why I'm shaking worse, but get that contrast paint painted onto the blues here. A lot of people use these contrast paints just to paint, and I think they do a really good job as just a wash. It gives like this mermaid blue color. Oh god, I'm shaking really bad. But the show must go on, as they say. So just push through this. Okay. We use Reichlin flesh for washing of golds. We also used it for washing the bolt gun colors too, so we'll see if we carry that through here too. It's really gonna brighten up our golds, make them really pretty and shiny. I'm gonna start speeding up here a little bit because my hands are losing it. Thank you. probably still kind of wet. But wash it anyway. We got to get the face. Crown, hair. It's a good thing about Reichland flesh, it's a red wash, so getting that in the hair and everything is fine, so that keeping it all the same color really kind of helped us out here. Helped me out. Wash the hands. Wash your hands. Now we can get the keep. Just really try to get in those dark areas. Keep the paint flowing in the same direction. It's like there's an earthquake. Just want to get those folds really good so you have the darkness in there. And all the cracks. Get in these little folds up here. It's going to really help sell the detail here. Pulling too much, you want to get it out as much as you can. Like here, like it's like super pulling in there, so just dry off your brush and tap it and it'll suck it up. Now for the shields and stuff, I don't think I'm gonna do what I did last time. I'm gonna take a known oil wash, which is a black wash. And we'll use that on the shield to give us a nice murky silver color. And then we'll use it also on here. And don't forget the bits on here. We're not gonna wash the purple because it is just a very flat surface on here. Won't really get a whole lot out of it. Maybe we can hit it with the black just to have it show up a little bit more right here, but everything else like down there is not really necessary. And that's pretty much it. I'm just gonna get down here on the headstone, just get those details showing, but it's still kind of wet, but we'll be okay. And that does it for our Akhelian Queen. Thanks for joining. you have any suggestions, as always, put them in the comments below. And we'll get our beauty shot here. Oops. Thanks for joining.